Do subscribe to Ekeeda channel and press bell icon to get updates about latest engineering, HSE and IIT JEE main and advanced videos.
Hello students, today we are studying chapter Genetic Basis of Inheritance. In that, we are studying topic Homozygous. Now, we all have heard that in Mendel's experiment, capital D was homozygous. How is that possible and what it is? Let's study today. Homozygous. When I say homozygous, it means similar gametes. Now, if an individual or a human being or a pea plant possess similar pair of alleles or similar pair of gametes for a given character, then that plant is said to be homozygous for that particular character. For example, if a parent of one generation or a progeny has capital D as one of its gamete. Now both capital D is similar. Then that progeny could be called as homozygous for the character height or length. Similarly, if a plant is having small t, then that plant could be called as homozygous for a character which is dwarf or short height. Now Mendel, what he did in certain experiments were, he crossed the capital T with the small t, or you can say he just crossed a homozygous tall plant with a homozygous dwarf plant. And when he crossed this, he came up with another law, the second law of Mendel. While segregating or differentiating the homozygous species with the heterozygous species, what Mendel noticed was the homozygous species, that is the capital T, were always dominant, whereas the heterozygous species, that is the small t, were always dwarf. So whenever in any experiments of Mendel or in genetics you see anything which is capital in letters in English alphabets is always homozygous, similar. For example, capital R is homozygous and dominant. Small r is recessive and weak. Homozygous. Now this is a term that you will always notice in genetics, especially in Mendel's experiments, or if you study Mendelian genetics or human genetics. This is the term that is widely used in diseases also. Certain diseases like sickle cell anemia, even your skin color, this term would be widely seen. An individual with the same allele or same gametes, or you can say same pair of genes for a given character is said to be homozygous for that particular character. For example, an individual or a pea plant could be said homozygous for the character of its length if it has got capital T and capital T. The homozygous individuals are always selected as parental generation because it is always believed, or Mendel always tried to cross pure breeds. When I say pure breeds, I could say capital T versus small t. And now these are pure breeds, just to obtain that F1 progeny in a normal parameter and to see the variations later on. Heterozygous parents when crossed can show large amount of variations and large amount of heredity, which Mendel did not want to see in his initial experiments of hybridization or crossing. Even when he did the law of dominance and codominance, he tried to first cross pure breeds, and then later he crisscrossed the F2 generation, F1 generation, so on. Now in homozygous parents, capital T stands for homozygous tall, whereas small t stands for homozygous dwarf, or you can say homozygous short. Students, this definition was about homozygous. What was capital T, capital T? What was small t, small t? We just came across this. And how this words or homozygous word affected all the three different laws of Mendel, we'll be studying that soon. I hope you all are clear with this concept of homozygous. Thank you.